Today on Emerging Business Report, meet Karen Barbour, the woman who planted her feet into the male-dominated assurity industry. Learn how her careful planning paved her way to success.
And thank you for joining us here on the Emerging Business Report, brought to you by the Center for Minority Business Development at Prince George's Community College. I'm your host, Sharrarne Morton. Today we're joined by Karen Barbour, founder and owner of the Barbour Group, a commercial insurance and bonding agency specializing in construction bonds. As the first woman founded an MBE certified surety agency in the state of Maryland, the Barbour Group provides bonding and insurance to contractors for projects located throughout the United States and internationally. Karen was awarded the Daily Record's Innovator of the Year Award, and the Barbour Group has won Inc.'s 5,000 fastest growing private companies in America 3 times. Karen was awarded the U.S. Small Business Administration's Maryland Small Business Person of the Year Award. Karen Barbour, thank you for joining us here on the Emerging Business Report. How are you today?
Great, thank you.
Good. We're going to talk a little bit about what your company does. And your company insures small and mid-sized businesses. You're really a bonding agency. In layman's terms, explain what that means.
In my business, insurance and bonding, the surety companies, insurance companies can't work directly with the public. They have to go through agents that are licensed and appointed in the state that they do business in. We are licensed from Alaska to Puerto Rico, and we're in approximately 30 states in terms of servicing contractors for bonding. What that means is that, not that I'm in every state, but we get referrals either from the federal government or from the Small Business Administration to assist small business in various parts of the country to help them get the bonding credit that they need.
And the bonding credit kind of gives them assurance that, or insurance, I should say, that they're able to do what it is that they say that they can do. I mean,
how does that work? Only in the United States can I be gainfully employed, because the United States passed an act called the Miller Act back in the 30s, basically stating that for contractors who want to seek work with the federal government, they must have a bond for contracts 100,000 and higher. But the federal acquisition and regulation guidelines now even stipulate that for projects at 30,000.
Oh.
So if contractors want to go after work, they definitely need bonding. And that is in the form of either a performance bond, which guarantees that they'll comply with the contract and perform their work, and a payment bond that guarantees that they will pay all of their subcontractors and suppliers.
So it's a guarantee for the federal government that this company can do what they say.
Yes, and it needs to be clearly stated that it's truly not insurance, because a bond is more like a banking line of credit. The contractor will pierce the corporate veil in many regards by signing a guarantee agreement called an indemnity agreement with the surety company that says that if I do fail to perform my job, and as surety you would have to pay out on the loss, you have every right to come after my corporate assets and personal assets to make you whole again.
Okay, so that's the difference between the bond and the insurance part of your
business. Bond is a third-party contract.
And how does the approval process work? Say, for instance, I'm a small business owner, and I'd like to start working with federal, state, and local governments.
Mm-hmm.
What would I do? What would be my first step?
The first step is the hardest step, is just trying to find the right agent that's going to be a good fit for your company and has the surety markets that they can bring to the table to service you. We have a myriad of companies that bond anywhere from zero to 250 million single jobs. So we have a large gamut. There are programs out there for contractors who are just starting out. If they want to pursue jobs up to $350,000, for example, there are companies who understand that this is a startup company that lack financials perhaps, but have good credit, and they can fill out a basically a two-page application and submit all the details. The company will pull a credit report, and based off their track record, their resume, they will approve bonds up to $350,000 for them without a financial statement.
Oh, okay. And you talk about good credit. I mean, that's important in everything that you do, but especially in business. Tell us the importance of that for small business owners.
Under that program, most sureties want to at least see a 650 credit score or higher. 650 is borderline, and you might have to explain some issues on your credit, skip payment or something of that nature. But ideally, if you have 700 and higher, you'll be good to go.
Okay, that's good to know. Now, what if you are recently retired from the government, for instance, or you're in the middle of a recession, as we are, and a lot of people have been laid off, and what they've done is they've started their own businesses. Mm-hmm. Maybe they don't have excellent credit, or maybe they've been laid off and they've been late on a few mortgage payments, et cetera, but they do want to start a small business in order to bring some income in. What would you suggest to them? What kind of advice would you give to a person like that?
Well, the Small Business Guarantee is a great avenue for contractors who don't have the best credit. The SBA bond guarantee works in this way. They partner with a surety company. The surety company has to approve the account first, but the SBA bond program, which is a federally funded, subsidized program, will back the bond for the contractor and the surety up to 90%. In some cases.
Let me stop right here, Karen, because this is really interesting information that our viewers need to know. But we're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back here on the Emerging Business Report. Stay tuned.
You need support. You need people to support you. So I had to find friends and people that were willing to be an advocate for me.